Hey everybody, it's Joel here with DesignFlow Labs, and in this video we're going to continue to build off of the initial pilot deployment of our low-code collaboration and automation platform from the initial video. So just to give a quick recap, what did we talk about in the initial video? Well, when we talk about starting to leverage something like a low-code collaboration and automation platform, there's a few key things we want to look at. First was, do we have an idea as to how we can use this to improve our organizational or team efficiency? In our demo example, we had a project management team who was tracking all of their projects in a spreadsheet. Wasn't really ideal. So what we did is we chose a platform called Podio. We're going to continue to leverage that platform in our demo today. And we did that so that we could bring all of our projects together, all of our project managers together into a centralized digital workspace. To manage those project records and collaborate about the status and current events related to those projects. So what you'll see, is we started with a couple of small applications. And again, that's one of the key tenets of kind of the initial phase of getting started, is start small, start simple. These platforms are very, very capable. They have a lot of features, and you don't have to boil the ocean right out of the gate. So what we did is we built a couple of small applications to help us manage both our projects, but also our related milestones. So as we move our project through certain phases, certain milestones were automatically created and related back to our project. So again, it helped cut down some of that mundane work. So what are we going to talk about today? How are we going to continue to build this momentum, off of our initial build out and success? Well, the first thing we're going to talk about is advancing our team collaboration. What we always like to talk about is inviting others to the party. So, when you're talking about a business process, in our example, we're talking about managing projects. There's usually things that happen on both ends of that, right? There's obviously things that happen after you've conducted a project and closed a project out. There's typically invoicing and debriefs and all those kinds of things. And there's also things that happen before you get to the project. There's customers that need to be engaged. There are opportunities that maybe a sales team manages. There are contracts that need to be put together and signed. So again, there are things that happen on both sides of your project. So what we really encourage clients to do as they start to get into their low-code journey is we encourage them to start to engage those teams who might have work that live on either side of the process that they're currently focused on. The second thing we talk about is refining our information organization. So one of the things that we talk about a lot, with our clients and potential clients is we don't just wanna build a system of record. We don't just wanna build yet another tool where a team or multiple teams have to go and spend all day doing data entry. What we want to do is we want to continue to refine the way that we categorize and organize information in the system so that can help us better automate certain key activities and bring additional focus for employees so they're not chasing data around. They're able to get in, see exactly what it is they need to focus on that day or that week or what have you, and get in and know what's going on and just jump right in. So we're going to talk about how we can continue to refine information to help us do that. Like I touched on, we're going to streamline a couple of additional workflows. So again, as you start to build things in and start to bring in more elements of your business processes, you're going to find areas that are ripe for automation. So maybe it's, at this step, this person is always assigned to go do a thing. Maybe the first step is just automating a task that gets created to remind them to go do that thing. Maybe down the road, it's something like, an email gets kicked off and sent. Maybe that's something you can fully automate and buy that person back a lot of time from not having to go do that manual work every single time that event occurs. So again, we're going to talk about how we can continue to build some automation capabilities, again, to drive that concept of system of guidance versus just a system of record where we're spending all day putting in information and getting nothing out of it. Finally, what we'll talk about and we'll build live is a couple of ideas to help build an automation strategy. So a lot of times there's things that the business wants to focus on any given quarter, any given year. And what we again always encourage clients to do is to start to ask, how can automation and better collaboration help us achieve those goals? So what we always see with these types of endeavors, especially when you're starting with maybe a pilot use case, or maybe a single team is starting to build some things out in a low-code collaboration platform, is kind of that concept, success breeds success. So one team will start to see some success. They'll start to see, some really good outcomes. Other teams will take notice. They'll say, hey, we really don't have a good process or a good system to do that kind of stuff. How are you doing it? Can you help us do that? So at this stage, when we're just starting to, again, build momentum off of our initial build out, we don't have to go have a full-blown automation strategy, but we need to be able to start to craft a process for us to, take ideas, review ideas, potentially plan projects and implement new capabilities, both for your team who may already be using the platform, but also for other teams that might be interested in working in the platform as well. So we'll talk a little bit about that as we get going here. Okay, so let's go ahead and move over to our workspace. And if you watch the first video, you might be able to pick out one or two different things here. But again, just a quick recap. What we started with was two applications. So we've got our digital workspace. Again, we built this inside of a low-code platform called Podio. We built our ability to track projects. So let's go in here and take a look. We have one project that's been completed. Let's drill into that. And you're able to see here that we were very, very quickly able to create an application to help us manage our project. So just like you would see in a spreadsheet, there's different fields. Fields represent different types of data. So we were able to come in and quickly create an application to manage these things. We gave, project names, status, due dates. There's a project manager assigned, project notes, this went great. There's really anything you can put in there. It's just an example of a field we can add. We also had a calculation field, which is a little bit more advanced, but the calculation field was built to show us kind of a summary of all of our open milestones. So because all of our related milestones for this project were marked as complete, nothing showing up in the table here, but you'll see as we go back through a demo example of another project, you'll see how that works. What we also did, I just mentioned the milestones, is we created a milestones app. So you can see from the project, I can get right over to these specific milestones related to this project. So let's go ahead and do that. And we can see those. We can see now I'm in the milestones application. I can change, the layout of these things. I can change it to a card view and say show it by status. We can see all those were complete. There's a lot of flexibility in these types of platforms for how you look at data, and collaborate around that data. In this case, these are milestones or actions that all need to occur as specific parts of the project. So what we did is we built in some automation to say, and we'll demo this again as we go through another example. But what we did is we said when we move to pre-flight, there's a couple of milestones that need to happen. The project manager is responsible for both those. It's the project review and the internal project kickoff. Once those are complete, we can move the project in progress, which then kicked off another milestone to conduct the customer kickoff call. So again, there's a lot of potential for orchestration depending on the way that you build projects or handle projects. If there's a very structured process, these platforms allow various ways to help build that structure in. So, those milestones or actions can be created. Or you can use it in more of an ad hoc fashion. You can create the ability to create more ad hoc milestones as you go through and as they come up and are needed. So we're not going to go too deep into that on this video. Again, I just wanted to recap what we had here already. So let's come back out to our activity page. And the first thing I talked about was, again, advancing our team collaboration. So what I talked about a little bit was the idea that, we started with our projects, and on either side of the project, there is work going on that can impact the project or is impacted by the project. So in this case, what we said is, all right, what are the things that Our project team kind of struggles with, in terms of collaboration and being ready for projects. And in this example, it was, hey, well, we're not always on the same page with what maybe, the sales organization was talking to the customer about as they were discovering and building the project contract. Maybe we want to have all of that stuff in one central workplace. So what we did is we engaged our sales team. Turns out they were using spreadsheets too in this example, also very inefficient. And we said, hey, we're managing our projects, in this unified workspace. Why don't we come manage your opportunities in the same workspace so that we can see the opportunities that you're working on and we can plan accordingly to deliver your projects that you sell. And the sales team can then also know exactly what's going on with their projects for their clients, and always be up to speed on what's going on, and not having those projects managed in a separate system where they don't have any, collaboration capabilities or visibility to what's going on. So what we did is we created a new application called Opportunities, and it's just a very simple application. So the sales team can come in, they can put an opportunity name, they can decide which status they want, they can add the opportunity, they can add themselves as the owner. We're tracking some revenue, and we've tracked our estimated close date. So what this allows us to do is this allows us to say, you know what, I've got a new opportunity. Let's call this op one, or actually this is op two because we already had a project. DesignFlow, that account is our project manager. In this case, we're going to decide that Joel is the owner of the opportunity. Let's just say this is a project here. Let's say we're planning on having this all wrapped up by the end of January. So I don't yet have any automation built in here because I want to do a couple of things and I want to talk about something before we do that. So one thing we talked about just a few minutes ago was also refining our information and how we categorize this information to help us drive and know what is next, right? What do we need to prepare for? What are the things that we need to know about so we can better move this work through its process? So now that I've got my opportunity created, I can come out here and I can see on our board, oh, hey, we've got, some revenue that's coming up that's at the discovery stage. That's still fairly early on. The project team might not yet need to be worried about it. What we can also do is we can also say, you know what, we probably also want to know, what is our revenue by estimated close date? And then let's show that by month. And let's do this. If you've watched these videos, I can't ever spell. Revenue by month. And let's go ahead and put this on our workspace homepage as well. So what we're going to do is we are going to just kind of stretch this out a little bit. Actually, I'm not sure why that's showing up that way. Let's redo this real quick. That was kind of strange. Let's create a report. Let's just show it deals by month. Well, let's just do it this way. So we can see here in January, we've got one deal. We could also do it by dollars. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's add that to, let's just call that upcoming revenue by month. And let's go ahead and put that out here. All right, so we can see here, couple additional pieces of information now. So since we're all working in the same workspace, the project team can see that there's project revenue coming through. It's a little bit early on, but we've got it set to potentially close in January. So now our project team knows about that. They can go in and view these things and collaborate with our sales organization, and they're able to, really stay on the ball with what's coming up, what's the latest update. Again, this is a low-code collaboration and automation platform. So by bringing these two teams together into a single workspace, we're able to help them better communicate, in the context of these various types of records, in this case, a sales opportunity, to be on the same page and always be up to date with what's going on. Now, what I also want to introduce, just in the spirit of refining our information, is maybe the way we've been tracking projects. Maybe we've always been tracking projects of one type. Maybe we've expanded our capabilities and now we've got two types of projects that we can implement for clients. So what the project team might do is they might say, you know what? We might now be able to say we're tracking project by type. Let's say this is type 1, type 2, and we'll just give these some different colors here. And just for grins, we're going to say our old project was type 2. So that's great for the project team. The project team is now able to start looking at, we don't have a lot of projects to report on, but they're able to start looking at and reporting on their projects now by project type. So if I want to create a report, I can create a report by type. And I can see that we had one project that was type 2. Now, that the project team is now tracking the type of project, they probably want to know from the sales organization, hey, what types of projects are you selling? So what we're going to do is we're going to come over, and again, we're going to modify this, and we're going to say, type 1, type 2, and I might get the colors backwards, but there we go. So now we're able to say, you know what? We are now tracking an opportunity that is type 1. Again, so our project team knows, hey, there's opportunities of certain kinds now coming towards us that we need to better be prepared and resourcing for. So again, as you kind of build out and start to expand and bring additional teams in, you want to stay flexible and aware of the different different categorizations, and different, pieces of information that are relevant to each team to make sure that you can move these things through the process, providing the maximum amount of visibility to everyone involved. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to talk about continuing to streamline processes. So, we've engaged a new team. We've got our sales organization tracking their opportunities here where project management can see it. The sales team can see the projects that they've sold and how those are going. Everybody's collaborating in one, digital centralized workspace. Life is great. But there's some things that we can start to continue to automate, to help us better stay on top of our work. So first thing I want to do is I want to create a workflow that tells us when a sales opportunity is marked as contract signed, we are going to tag the actual close date. We have a hidden date field here so that the leaders of the organization can report on that kind of thing. But we're going to tag the date that the deal was actually closed, and we're going to create a project that relates back to this opportunity. So let's say maybe one of the things that the sales team organization added was maybe they added a field for op notes, and there was a bunch of notes, lots of things we learned about the client project along the way. There'd probably be far more notes in there than this, but those kinds of things, that kind of knowledge is helpful to the project team as we get going. But what we're gonna do is I'm gonna grab my workflow. This is the workflow engine. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new workflow, a new automation that says when an opportunity is updated, so we can see here the trigger is an item is updated, and I'm updating something inside of my opportunities app. It's just a very simple workflow. What I'm going to do is say, when an opportunity status is changed, when it's moved to contract sign, I want to create a new project in the projects app. I want the related opportunity. I want it to relate back to this opportunity. So we link those two records together. The project manager, still a very small team. DesignFlow is always going to be our project manager. And I'm going to auto set the project status to not started. But since I also just introduced, the concept of project type, I want to be able to communicate to the project team what type this is coming in as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to say, when the project record is created, the project type is going to equal the opportunity type. So we've got that. And then let's just for fun, let's add a comment. New closed opportunity. Gosh, I can't spell to save my life. Let's give this the opportunity name. actually, you know what? Yeah, we'll do that. We'll do that in another spot. I was going to pass the notes over. In any event, what we're going to do here is we're going to save this. So save. Let's move that over here. So now what will happen is when my contract is signed, so let's say, we're at contracting. Again, all of these changes will be reflected, out at the workspace level. So people can see how things are working through here. So we can see it's contracting. Let's go back in there. We're negotiating. Again, you can report on these kinds of things. You can drive additional tasks and activities that need to happen. You can automate lots of different things. What we're going to do, though, is we're going to say contract was signed. And what that's going to do is that is going to create us a new project record over in our projects app. So let's go take a look. We can see here that our project was created. One of the things I forgot in the automation was to create a project name. Let's call this project 2. But we can see all of the other data came over. So we know because the sales opportunity was related to project type 1, it's project type 1. Our project manager can come in and say, you know what, we can start this February, get it done in the same month. We've got some project notes, and we can see our related opportunity here as well. What I can also do now, in order to orchestrate the flow of work, is I can say, you know what, we're ready to move into pre-flight. What that's going to do is that is going to create two milestones that are now related to our project, and we will be able to see those populate here. There we go. So we just saw these populate. What I did, again, is I have this little table here that shows us our related milestones. So if I refresh, we can see here our milestones are down at the bottom. But maybe there's just a lot of scrolling that you don't want to deal with. So you can see here, we used a calculation field again just to build a very simple table so you can see some key information from those milestones. But now for my project record, I can go back and see all of the information from the opportunity. And, if I'm on my opportunity, I can see now that I've got a project and it is in pre-flight. So again, we're bringing all of those things together into a single workspace. So now we can see, our opportunity moved off the board because it was closed, but we've got one active project with two milestones that haven't started. So again, all of our teams that are involved in these things, can go in, from this dashboard, they can create, we're not going to go into it too deep in this video because we're running a little long, but they can create individual dashboards that have reports very specific to their individual work, accessible on their homepage that looks very similar to this. And it helps everybody focus on, again, what it is they need to do from a guidance perspective. What is the system guiding them to focus on, as it relates to the role that they play, whether they're a sales, salesperson working opportunities, a project manager managing projects, maybe you're a member of the project team delivering on these milestones related to a project. We're tying all of these things together into a system of guidance where we know what's happening every step of the way and we know what needs to happen next. We're not ever wondering, oh, hey, what's going on with that thing? What's going on with this? We're not chasing emails or emailing different spreadsheets around. Everything is being collaborated on, and we're automating a lot of that mundane work here in our digital workspace. Okay, so now what we want to touch on for the last part of this is the concept of starting to build out an automation strategy. So like I mentioned earlier, as teams start to bring their work into a centralized workspace, or maybe they've got a couple of workspaces, people see that, they see the success that they've had, and they want to be able to participate in it as well. So how do you do that? How do you start to build a strategy around your automation and your capabilities that you've got here, so that you can, again, start to plan and implement new capabilities for different teams? Well, it doesn't have to be super hard. It doesn't ever have to be super complex, but you can start super easy with this. So what we're going to do, we're going to do this on the fly, is we're going to create a new app. We're just going to call it Automation Ideas. And we're going to use it to track ideas. An item name is an idea. Let's just see what we get here. I like that one. Let's do this in a card layout. Let's create our app. Idea name. I'll come back to the idea type. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to set up just a very basic application to track automation ideas. So we're going to say it's in review, it's approved, maybe put on hold. Let's do it this way. Oh, idea type. Let's just do this kind of natural language, something not working. Build something new. So we'll just have a few different idea types here. We'll keep it very simple. Because here's the idea with this. What we want to be able to do is we want to create a spot where people can come in and easily submit ideas, and a team of people, maybe it's the person who's most familiar with your platform. Some organizations get to a point where they've got an admin, or a partner like DesignFlow that works with their admin to help manage all of this. But somebody would come in and see these ideas come in, and they would start to review those, right? And they would start to say, all right, that sounds like it's something that we've got the time and resources to do, should be pretty easy. Hey, maybe that's biting off a little bit more than we're ready for. Let's put it on hold. But what we want to do, and this is a capability that not just Podio, but a lot of low-code collaboration platforms have, is we want to turn this into a web form. So we want to make it super easy for our employees to be able to come in and submit ideas. So we've got the idea name. We don't want them to see status. Okay, so we've got this. Let's go ahead and change our title and description, automation, idea form, submission. So we can set these fields here. We can select a theme. I'm kind of custom or kind of partial to this theme. It's very simple. You can add custom CSS. We're not going to touch that in this video, but you can use that to add some formatting. There's options to get a logo up here. We're not going to do any of that right now. Button text, submit my idea. We'll just change that. Thank you for your idea. It has been submitted for review. So, okay, so we've got that. Let's go ahead. Oh, we want them to be able to choose an attachment. So let's go ahead and save that. And here's what we're going to do. We're going to grab the shareable link, and we're going to go back to our workspace homepage. And we're going to do this. We're going to add a tile where we can put important links or helpful links. We're going to add one, the URL we just grabbed. And we're just going to call this automation idea form. We're going to add that here. We don't have any other links right now. But you can see where this would be helpful from kind of a jump off standpoint, you know, for people to go submit different things like requests to different departments that might be working in a platform like this. In this case, we're just submitting ideas, but you could be submitting a request to a legal team, to an IT team, to a human resources team. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and click our idea. And we come over to our form. We're going to say our idea name is build a new flow to auto set fields on new idea, because we haven't done that. Improve something that exists. So I'm going to submit my idea. So what we see now in our workspace page in the activity feed, this is the running feed of all of the things happening in our workspace. As we see, there's a new post. Hey, we got a new idea. Let's go take a look at that. We can see here that, you know, something that exists. I didn't capture that correctly for the idea submitted by. But what we're going to do is we're actually going to come back and we are going to build another workflow real quick that helps us just tag this with, you know, a new idea. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm just getting this pulled up here. Okay. And it's a very simple workflow. New idea created. One item is created. We're going to update this item. And we're going to say the status is new. And let's just leave that alone for right now. So now moving forward, all of these will come in as new and we'll be able to see those. So let's go take a look at this. And right now it's sorted by idea by type. What we can do is we can say, you know what, I don't like that view. I only want to see those with status of new, in review, hold, or approved. And I want to change this to be by status. And I'm going to save this view, open automation ideas, save this to team views, split by status. Actually, you know what? I'll split it by type. So we can now see here, and we have a central place to work on these different ideas. So, you know, this one, build a new idea or build a new flow to auto set fields on a new idea. You know, we just did that. It's in review. Maybe the team talked about it. It's relatively easy to do. It's approved. Let's go back and let's do another one. And if we refresh, we will see that came in and it is auto set to status new. So this one is now complete. And again, we've got a very simple way now to take in new ideas to keep our automation, you know, capabilities developing, get new teams excited about the capabilities that we've got in terms of collaboration and automation. So Again, these are just some very simple next steps you can take. We're going to continue to build off of this video and mature this as we go. But if there's anything that you've got questions on or would like help with, just hit the contact us button in the video, and we'll be sure to get in touch with you and talk about, you know, how these low-code collaboration and automation platforms could really help your team here moving into the new year. Thanks. Have a great day.